we're thinking today in our service about Lent, because this is the first Sunday in the season of Lent, a very special season in the Christian year. And I'm going to just show a little video clip now to remind us about some things to do with Lent, and you must pay close attention, because then we're going to have a little quiz about Lent after that. See how much you know about the season of Lent. So here's the video clip to tell us a little bit about it. The day before Lent is called Mardi Gras, Pancake Tuesday, Shrove Tuesday. Okay, on you go. You're going for B. You're going to go for A. Right, you go over there then. Okay? And where anybody else? Anybody going for C? Shrove Tuesday? No. So most of you, Leslie thinks it's Mardi Gras. You think it's Pancake Tuesday, and nobody thinks it's Shrove Tuesday. Well, this is the one question where every answer is correct. Because the day before Lent is called all of these things. Mardi Gras, which I believe in French means Fat Tuesday. Is that right? Thank you, you learned a few words in French. Pancake Tuesday, we probably know best as, which is why most of you are probably going for Pancake Tuesday, but it's also the proper name is sometimes Shrove Tuesday. So the rest of them, though, there will only be one answer.
Right. I thought I'm going to tell you a story about my mum. I don't think you heard many stories about my mum, but when she was a little girl, she would always refer to herself as the child. And so, for example, when her granny would ask her what she was doing in the other room, my mum would reply, "The child is standing and watching," or whatever else she was doing. And another characteristic trait of my mom's was that she didn't like fish and wouldn't eat it under any circumstances. So her grandparents who brought her up tried all sorts of different tricks to make her eat it, and they would sometimes disguise it as something else. So one day, they came up with this magnificent idea to take a slice of bread, put some fish on it, and cover it with jam. Don't ask how on earth they came up with this bright idea, but they did, and they actually thought it would work. Well, surprise, surprise, it didn't. So my mom, unsuspecting, had a mouthful of her delicious bread with jam, and the moment she realized it wasn't exactly what she thought it would be, she spit it out with disgust and said with indignation, "The child doesn't like fish." And in a way, Lent is a bit like my mom's special sandwich. We need to take a mouthful to determine what there is inside. Unlike my mom, though, we do want to discover the hidden layers and learn from them. We do want to look for the special and unexpected message God has for us this Lent. Lent is a period when we prepare ourselves for Easter, the greatest Christian festivals, when we remember Jesus dying on the cross and then rising from the dead on the glorious Easter morning. Some of us will give something up for Lent, like chocolate or Facebook or going to the cinema. Others might take something up, like prayer or Bible study. Whatever we do know, it's designed to help us to get closer to God and listen to His message to us. We're looking for God's revelation, God's guidance, God's newness and freshness in our lives. Today we read a story about Jesus taking time off to think and pray and to look for God and His will for his life. It was when he grew up, but before he was saved. It was before he made any sick people better, before he told any amazing stories, before he did any miracles, before lots of people got to know him. Jesus wanted to go away by himself for a while. He wanted to be alone, and so he decided to go for a walk out into the desert. Some commentators suggest that through the 40 days in the desert, Jesus was retracing the steps of his people to their place of origins, the Exodus wilderness, where they spent 40 years of their life after they left Egypt. He did this in the hope of discovering where they went wrong. He faced again the forces that attracted them into idolatry and injustice, because to build a different future, he had to confront the past. The struggle of Jesus with the nation's past, trying to understand it so that he could change it, was described as his struggle with Satan. While many Christians no longer accept Satan as a personal being, the figures of Satan and the demons represent forces in the world, like racism or sexism, ethnocentrism, addictions, that resist God's aim for all to experience love and justice. Girl Guides came here today to celebrate their Thinking Day, and this year they focus especially on child mortality and maternal health. I like the fact that you take time off to think first before you act. And this is a very good example for us here in the church. That's what we are asked to do during Lent. Think, pray, and take time with God before we act. And that's what Jesus did in today's reading. If we follow Jesus in his fighting against injustice and exclusion and poverty, we should follow him in taking time off to be alone, to be in silence, to be with God in this special way, letting him speak to our past, our present, and our future.
Mums protect you from danger. Mums feed you and give you water. Mums buy you clothes. Mums give you a nice home. Mums give you a cosy bed. Mums love you no matter what. So let's all say thank you to your mums for being so kind and caring. Amen.
Mothers wash, scrub and dry. They make us food to stay alive. They take us to the doctors when we are ill. She treats us well, so don't complain. She lets us have fun when there is rain. I love my mum, she is so special. A mother's work is never done. I am so lucky to have a mum like my mum. Amen.
Mums. Mums are special. Mums are caring. Mums are loving and trying to do their best. Mums help us do everything. They take us on holiday and stuff like that. Mums give us a nice home. Mums love us and mums buy us lots and lots of things. Mums work hard and provide for us. Amen.
Thank you very much. Now we're going to have Hugh and Fraser leading us.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, as we gather together on this thinking day, we thank you for the gift of the Sisterhood of Worldwide Guiding. We remember as we join together here in this place that all over the world, guides in different countries are coming together to share friendship and to celebrate Thinking Day. We thank you for the opportunity of shared interest and fellowship given to us through guiding, and we pray that we can continue to reach out to our fellow guides on a local, national and international level. We realise that Thinking Day is all about remembering all sections of girl guiding all over the world. And as we contemplate this, we know that although we attend our guide meetings in a stable and wealthy country, in many other countries this is not the case. Perhaps we should always remember how lucky we are. Although Thinking Day is all about guiding, this should not stop us thinking about all people who are less fortunate than ourselves. And of course we realise that although thinking is a starting point, action is also required to make a difference. Lord, this Thinking Day, help us to convert our thoughts into actions and help us to make a difference, however small. As members of Girl Guiding, we all take a promise to do our best to love our God, to serve our Queen and country, to help other people, and to keep the Brownie or Guide laws. In an ever-changing world, grant us the strength to keep this promise and to turn our words into deeds. And as we leave this place, grant us a little more peace and a little more understanding of what it means to be part of the worldwide Sisterhood of Guiding. Amen.
Now I'd like to invite Joyce Cowie forward for the renewal of the Girl Guides Promises.
Good morning. Could I invite the rainbows to stand up and make their promise? Now I'm happy to cheat because I don't know your promise very well, so I've got words. Is that okay? Put the paper down the side, the rainbow side. One. I promise that I will do my best to love my God and be kind and helpful. Can I invite all Brownies, all guides, all geysers to stand up, and any other member of the congregation who was in guiding who would like to renew the promise? Okay. I promise that I will do my best
to love my God,
serve my Queen and my country, to help other people and to keep the Brownie Guide law.
March of the Colours.